We know that satisfying the Cauchy-Riemann equations is a necessary condition for differentiability of a complex function. But what is a sufficient condition? That's what you will learn in this video, and we'll see a few examples as well. So suppose we have a complex function from its domain to its codomain, and suppose that 0 is in the domain, and a small disk radius epsilon is also in the domain of f. Then we can write f of z as u plus r times v, and then f is differentiable at the points x0, y0 if both the Cauchy-Riemann equations are satisfied. Okay, we knew that already, that was a necessary condition, and it's sufficient if also the ux, uy, vx and vy are all continuous at x0, y0. Then you're done. So your function is differentiable. First of all, you need Cauchy-Riemann, you need to check Cauchy-Riemann. Second, you need that all partial derivatives are continuous. Well, the second restriction is less severe than the first one because most of our functions are continuous. Let's take a look at a few examples. F of z equals z squared. Now, of course, we can use a definition to see whether it's differentiable or not, but let's see what happens if we use the Cauchy-Riemann equations. So z squared equals x squared minus y squared plus 2 times x times y times I. So what happens if you compute ux, etc.? Ux equals 2y, ui equals minus 2x, minus 2y, vx equals 2y, and vy equals 2 times x. So let's check. We need ux to be equal to vy, so ux equals vy. So that's correct. And we need uy to be equal to minus vx, while uy equals minus 2y, vx equals 2y. So indeed, uy equals minus vx. So we know that f is differentiable, because also the ux, uy, etc., they are all nice and continuous. So we can write our derivative as ux plus r times vx, which is ux equals 2x, vx equals 2y, so we find 2x plus 2y times I. And if you write again z equals x plus iy, you find f prime equals 2z, which won't surprise you, of course. Now what happens if we try this for our f of z equals the norm of z squared? We saw before that it's not differentiable except in 0. So what happens if we try to apply Cauchy-Riemann? Well, we have u equals x squared plus y squared and v equals 0. So ux equals 2x and uy equals, it should be plus 2y. And the derivatives of v are all 0. So continuity of ux and uy, etc. is no problem. But what happens if you try to apply Cauchy-Riemann? Well, ux has to be equal to vy, so 2x equals 0, so x equals 0, and uy equals minus vx, so 2y equals minus 0 equals 0. Doesn't matter, y has to be 0 as well. So the only point where Cauchy-Riemann equations are satisfied is x equals y equals 0. So only in the origin Cauchy-Riemann equations are satisfied, so f is only differentiable and z equals 0, and there ux and vx are both 0, so f prime of 0 equals 0. We already found this using the definition, but here you see that you can find it as well using the theorem and the Cauchy-Riemann equations. The latter is usually a bit easier. And then, finally, this third example, f of z equals u plus r times v. Is f differentiable, and if so, where, what's the derivative? So we compute again. Ux equals 3x squared, uy equals 0, vx, v doesn't depend on x, so vx equals 0, and vy equals 3 times 1 minus y squared times minus 1, so minus 3 times 1 minus y squared. Now, ux, etc., they are all nicely differentiable. The second condition is hardly ever the problem. And then let's take a look at Cauchy-Riemann. Well, we have vx equals minus uy, so this part is fine. But we also need ux equals vy, so 3x squared equals minus 3 times 1 minus y squared. Equation over here. Well, I can divide by 3 and bring the 1 minus y squared to the left-hand side, and you find that you have to satisfy x squared plus 1 minus y squared equals 0. So the sum of 2 squared equals 0. It's only possible if both of them are 0, so if x squared equals 0, so x equals 0, and if 1 minus y squared equals 0, so if y equals 1. So f is differentiable only at x equals 0, y equals 1, so at z equals I, and you can find this derivative as f prime at I equals 0. So now you can see how you can determine whether a function is differentiable or not. Just use Cauchy-Riemann equation, see whether those partial derivatives are continuous and where the Cauchy-Riemann equations are satisfied.